If you guys are looking for super cheap, fast, and reliable Madden 21 coins, look no further than my sponsor, MuttReserve.com. Coins are currently discounted, guys. They got 24/7 support. They're super awesome to work with. Head on over, use code Poodle for an additional 15% off your order. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, I'm going to be going over what you should be expecting, what you need to be doing right before kickoff promo part 2. Now, kickoff promo part 2 will be dropping tomorrow sometime around hopefully 10:30, the usual time. Now, I'm pretty excited because typically kickoff, like any promo part 1 is typically just like the bread at dinner. You just get in the beginning, it's cool and all. But the banger usually comes as the second part, typically. So Byron Jones was good. The heroes are pretty good. So I can only imagine that the part 2 could be a banger. It could be really good. It could be super exciting. So I hope they do this well. I'm going to go over what you guys can pretty much be expecting from the part 2 of this promo. Kind of how I think they're going to handle this. And kind of just like I think like what you guys should be doing beforehand. Now to start you guys off before we get into today's video, guys, do remember starting up the Poodle Squad. All you guys got to do to be a part of it, it's pretty much Noti Gang. All you got to do, you guys comment Noti Gang anyway, so I want some fun out of this. All you got to do to enter and be shouted out in every video, first off, is go down below, turn on that Noti bubble. You see it right next to the subscribe. I assume you guys are subscribed already. Comment it down below, like the video, and comment down below, Poodle Squad. All you got to do is little thing to enter, and I will announce it every day. Now, for today's video, it is Day Galloway. Shout out to him for being a part of the Poodle Squad. Thank you so much for being here and supporting every single day. And yeah. Pretty much for that, we'll be giving out a gift card in today's later video, so make sure to go check that out. But yeah, let's get into the video. Make sure to subscribe, smash the like button. Let's get into this. So, coming over to the kickoff promo part 1 and showing you guys what you kind of expect. Typically, a part 2 of a promo is a replica of the first part, typically just different players. So, this was an AFC Master, so I'm hoping we get an NFC Master this time. So, obviously, Byron Jones with Miami Dolphins, which is the AFC's. Hopefully, we get an NFC Master. Now, who could that be? Guys, there are so many options. You know, NFC East, NFC West, NFC South, NFC North. So many, you know, 16 different teams. So many people it could be. Byron Jones was not expected at all. So, I'm not going to go here and predict for you guys. But we got a cornerback, so I imagine might be on the offensive side of the ball. A wide receiver would be really cool. A tight end. It's probably going to be a quarterback. I mean, it's probably I won't be a lineman. So, it's probably going to be a wide receiver, tight end. Hopefully, they keep it depth because it'll be more fun to get. Now, so you can expect another 90 overall master. Now, if they're really cool, they'll make it a 91 master, but I doubt there's no reason to differentiate, so it might just end up staying 90 overall master replica. And then 4 more heroes again. Now, these heroes weren't exactly from one specific conference because we got Gurley in the NFC, Trent Williams in the NFC, Linval Joseph in the NFC, and then Yannick Ngakoue. Oh, well, Ngakoue going to the Minnesota Vikings. So actually, these are all NFC. So we got an AFC hero, AFC master, NFC heroes. So we could probably expect 4 AFC heroes and 1 NFC master. So that'd be pretty cool to end up seeing if they do end up going that route. And then I hope they get more solos. So my guess is that they may get more solos for 1 more free player again. So make sure you have your day ready tomorrow to play some solos. And they may even introduce another house rules. Now, it's going to probably be the same rewards, but they may introduce a new house rules with different rules and regulations to go ahead and kind of mix it up a little bit. Although I don't think they'll add more tokens and rewards. It would be pretty cool. Hopefully we get another free one. They didn't say it the first time, but I was kind of hoping we would end up getting one. Now, as far as what you're going to do tomorrow, guys, you want to get that coin stack up today. Now, the market's super high, so definitely be taking advantage of things that you can be selling right now to get your coins up for tomorrow, because tomorrow you're going to want the master, right? Byron Jones, day 1 went down to almost like 360K, 380K. That's a great value for Byron Jones. And then they go up in price. The masters typically go up in price afterwards. So, as of right now, the market's super high, so make sure you are selling some stuff that you might not need right now, like Richard Seymour, Dan Marino. Look at the price of training right now. Price of cards are through the roof right now. Make sure you go ahead and take advantage and pick that up. Now, if you guys do need coins or training, remember, Mutt Reserve does sell coins, cards, and training, and they currently, everything's like half off, crazy discounted. Plus code Poodles, additional 15% off, so go take advantage of that. Link will be down below in the description. But if you need coins for tomorrow and you have players, go ahead and sell them. You can make crazy coins. Everyone's going crazy for training to get the heavyweight cards. As you can see, the entirety of the market is crazy expensive right now. It'll come back down, but for now, it's going to be expensive because everyone's buying training, powering up cards, picking up new heavyweights, building their stacked O-line for weekend league, especially a lot of competitive players who may need that O-line for weekend league, of course, and seasons, squads as well. So in my opinion, guys, definitely be stacking up the coins for tomorrow. Now, in terms of, you know, other stuff, you don't need much else besides coins. So if you want to get the master set done, typically it costs me about it costs 800K without the free player, 600K with the free player. Typically, that's what it was. Now, if you do wait a little bit, they will come down a bit more. But with the price of training being so high, you're going to have to snipe them instantly. You definitely want to be on top of them sniping those cards, because if you wait too long, they could come back up because of training. But I imagine you could do the set, or you can just get the player for 360, 400K when he does come out. Now, again, if it's a great player and you're going to want it, definitely want to pick up. Masters are always fun to add to the team. Masters typically last a pretty decent time on your team. One of the higher overalls. Now, of course, if it's a 90, it'll be just like Byron Jones. If it's a 91, it'll be even better. But I don't think it's going to be a 91 for the most part. They've done it before. I just don't think I can imagine it being so. Now, again, definitely go through your team and check. It's like, for me personally, to build up coins for tomorrow, I went through my team and I checked, like, what do you make coins back on? Especially when you can sell a card and make coins back. So if you look right here, I had Larry Allen, right? I was just trying to sell him. I'll put him back up. I had Larry Allen, Merlin Olsen, and, well, I had Joe Thomas, and I had Jason Kelce. So Jason Kelce was going for like 90K. So I put him up and I sold him because I knew that Brandon Linder was coming out, and he sold. So 90K for a center that's only an 85 overall is just an insane value. Then we got Larry Allen, who's going for 240,000 coins when I bought him for 165, 170. So again, an absolute snag right there. So I'm going to put him up. I'm telling you guys, you can make so many coins. So after reduction, everything. Let's say I put him up for, let's see, 230. 230 sounds fair, right? Give him a little 10K reduction because you want to undercut a little bit to make sure it will sell and no one undercuts you. So 230, after reduction, end up about 210, 218. So I made about 40,000 coins to 50,000 coins, 60,000, somewhere between there, depending on reduction, everything, off of my Larry Allen. So I'm making coins. I made another like 40K off Jason Kelce. I'm just making coins left and right. Now, the only reason I haven't sold these two guys here because they actually are super glitchy on my team. So I definitely want to still compete in Weekend League. Isaiah Simmons, I bought for 280. He's going for 330 again, but reduction is not the greatest value. But a lot of cards, you can make coins while also getting coins for tomorrow. Then take those coins, pick up a master tomorrow. And then when things drop back down, buy your players back. Now you have a master that you essentially got for free because all the coins you're going to make off selling extra, like my 60K, 50K, you're going to get that master for a super discounted price. And then, of course, you could always sell him back later and then make an extra 50K on him later, like Byron Jones when he went back up at first. So again, it's a win-win every way around. That's kind of why I like picking up those masters. But yeah, I've been going through my team, selling some base elites, selling some stuff that I see like goes for 50, 60K. Just so many great values making. Now, I don't know if that's my Larry Allen that sold. I would be super excited if it was. No, it's just, I always get stupid. I always get notifications after I put stuff on the block. But guys, that pretty much wraps up the bulk of this video. To wrap it all up, guys, kickoff promo part 2 tomorrow. Expect more solos, hopefully. Well, definitely more solos. Because like, if you guys see here, the milestones, typically they give it away, or they probably intend to. So to get to the top tier, you're going to need 160 trophies, and I believe you're going to have only 80 from here, and the other 80s in the NFC, of course. Now, I'm hoping that there's maybe more solos beyond that. So NFC for sure unlocks tomorrow. Now, again, I'm hoping there's more solos, like maybe they add like some cool LTD solos for kickoff. Not entirely sure, but I'm really hoping we get another master. I expect another master at the least. Because, again, last year we got, like, 4 masters. This year we only got 1. We did get heroes, which kind of make up for it. But at least give us 2 masters, 8 heroes versus 4 masters, then, if that's going to be the case. But pretty much wraps it up, guys. Remember, make sure to build up your coin stack. Make sure to take advantage of the very, very high training carried market right now. So you guys can go ahead and just triple your investment right now. And then go ahead and sell it all back, pick it all up, and then end up with more coins than you started with. A lot of ways to take advantage today, specifically for tomorrow, so make sure you get on top of that. But guys, about it for the video. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you're new to the channel or you want to join the Poodle Squad, all you got to do is turn on the noti bell, boys, like the video, and you're probably subscribed. Comment down below, Poodle Squad, and that's all you got to do, guys. But that's it. Enjoy the rest of your day. Let me know down below what you expect for tomorrow. What master would you guys expect to be getting one? That's about it. Enjoy the rest of your day. I'm out. Peace.